from France, Antonio Buono. From Scandinavia Baltics, Anton Huza. From Spain and Portugal, David Andres. From Canada, Benjamin Mouhois Langlais. From Mediterranean countries, Constantina Vulgari Contesopoulou. From the USA, John Talby IV. From Southeast Asia, Jake Kelly. From Pacific, John Rivera. From Japan, Yasuhiro Fujio. From China, Chanwai Poon. From East Europe, Markin Popielar. From Russia, CIS, Ruslan Evstignayev. From Benelux, Frederik Shastrol. From Northeast Asia, Ji Yang Chen. From Italy, Edoardo Fumagalli. From the UK and Ireland, Killian Crowley. From Switzerland, David Velti. From South America, Elizabeth Puccio Landeo. From Germany and Austria, Falco Weiss. From Central America, Caribbean, Oscar Segundo. From Africa, Middle East, Vuzumuzi Ndlovu.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the third edition of Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2018 for the third time in Milan, more than ever. Capital of food, the competition is the final chapter of a journey around the world searching for the most talented young chef. Tonight we have the best 21, give them a round of applause. The 21 young chef emerged from over 2,000 contestants from five continents, and they fought in the kitchen in the last 2 days over the title. Each young chef was tutored by a star chef and judged by a panel of seven of the world's best chefs. Tonight we celebrate their talent, their passion, their ideas, of course. And with me during the final show is a true expert of the world of international food. He's a host, but also a chef herself. Please welcome Angela May. Hello, welcome.
Oh, thank you so much, Alessandro. My goodness, what an amazing entrance these guys have made today.
They're pro.
It is so exciting to be here at Sanpellegrino Young Chef this year. As you just mentioned, we are here to honor talent and to witness the evolution of the next generation of first-class chefs. Over the past 2 days, I've been poking around into the kitchens. The chefs have been so kind to chat with me, tell me what they've been using, some of the ingredients they've brought with them as well. We have seen such an intense competition here with a lot of nerves and some very cool chefs as well. So I hope during the finale today that I can be helpful in recounting the journey and witness some of the great stuff that these chefs have been doing.
So are you ready for the final?
I am.
Let's get the party started. Please, guys, take a seat. Thank you very much. We'll see you all in a few minutes. We said that Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2018 is a celebration of talent, and above all, is the opportunity for these 21 young chefs to show what they are capable of. And how do we know? Because that's the exact things that happen with their predecessors.
The winner of the first Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2015 award is from UK, Ireland, Mark Moriarty. The Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2016 is Mitch Leonard.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mark Moriarty and Mitch Leonard.
Hello.
Good to see you again, my friend. How are you? Hello, it's good to see you again. Welcome back in Milan. How does it feel?
Yeah, it's great. I'm even nervous looking at it for the guys, so I'm glad I don't have to be in it this year.
Yeah, you know how they feel.
Yeah, no. Yeah. Especially now the next hour is a big time where it's all the nerves. But again, it's a great opportunity and it's just exciting for everyone to be here, part of such a great event, and just look at it.
Yeah, you can give them some advices. How your life changed since that day?
It's definitely offered lots more opportunities. I was able to use it in my own way. It opened a lot of doors, created a whole network of people I could connect with, and allows me to make decisions in my career, and I've really kind of elevated me at a very fast rate, I suppose, in a way that I couldn't have if I hadn't won the competition.
Yeah, it's good to hear.
And what about you, Mitch? How does it feel to be back here on this stage?
I'm a little less nervous than I was, for sure. I know how it feels presenting to seven people that you highly respect.
Our seven sages, yes.
Yes, exactly. And then just everybody who's a mentor as well, and all the chefs. It's very nervous when you're up there doing it, but it feels a lot better this year.
Yeah, exactly, on this side of the fence. Tell me, how has your life changed since you won the title?
I mean, I've been able to travel more than I ever have before, see places that I have never had the opportunity to go to, work in restaurants with chefs that I, again, highly respect, and you know, without that, I wouldn't have had that opportunity. And where else can you be in a room full of people and be able to talk to all these chefs, all these people that you idolize better than you can here?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's an amazing scene, and everybody here is so open and willing to share their ideas.
Absolutely.
Speaking of that, do you have any advice for everybody that's now sitting in the shoes that you were sitting in previously?
Wow. Given that you're not competing anymore, I don't really have great advice for you. No, just, you know, as long as you believe in what you're doing, and I think that you were honest with the dish that you created, and you knew that it represented yourself, and it represented where you're from, I think that, you know, you should be very confident and you should be very proud of anything that you've done today or yesterday.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you so much, Mitch.
Guys, as in many other fields nowadays, your popularity is also celebrated by the internet. The social networks is the place where people can discuss and share about the world of food. Fine Dining Lovers, People's Choice Award, is the online magazine by Sanpellegrino and Acqua Panna followed the adventure of all the contestants and told their stories during this journey and gave the opportunity to foodies to vote for their favorite young chef. I ask Mr. Giorgio Mondovì, Business Executive Officer Italy of Sanpellegrino Group, to join us on stage to announce the winner.
Mitch, why don't you move here?
Giorgio, welcome. You have the envelope.
Opening the envelope with the microphone is a bit difficult. Let me tell you one thing before. This is the one of the most important awards. This is the outcome of 30,000 people voting. I am among one of those voters, but I don't know. I will not tell you who I did vote with. Two. Listen, it's... If you think that you have 30,000 people voting, it means that the magnitude of what you guys have achieved, the followers that you have, is amazing. So let's go quickly to see and realize and discover who is the winner.
Yeah, who's the winner?
So the winner of the Fine Dining Lovers Award People's Choice is Elizabeth Puccio Landel.
Congratulations, Elizabeth, come on and join us.
Congratulations, Elizabeth.
So Elizabeth's dish was a lightly pickled mackerel, and she was celebrating mom, which is also so important today on Mother's Day, isn't it? Would you like to say a few words, or maybe just even hello to all of your followers, and thank you for voting?
Thank you so much. And I'm very happy to stay here. It's a big experience. It's my first time here. It's great. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, and congratulations.
Congratulations, Elizabeth. Thank you, Mr. Mondovì. Mark Mitch, good luck on everything. It's been nice to see you again. Thank you, Angela.
Thank you.
Thank you, Angela. See you all later. We are having just a hint of the talent we've been talking so far. These 21 young chefs are judged by a superstar panel. And when I say superstar, I know what I'm talking about, because these are the emperors of the kitchen. Please welcome the seven sages, our jury.
In her San Francisco restaurants, she transforms ingredients into masterpieces. She's a two Michelin star chef and ambassador for female chefs worldwide. Chef Dominique Crenn. She was the first woman to hold three Michelin stars outside of France. To her, being a chef means being talented, but also having respect for others. From the prestigious Enoteca Pinchiori in Florence, Chef Annie Feold. She's the chef behind Chibo, Lusso, and countless other culinary ventures in the Philippines. Voted Asia's best female chef in 2016. Thanks to her work, Philippine cuisine finally has the limelight. Chef Margarita Forres. He began in Australia, aged 15, working in a local fish restaurant. Since then, he has achieved two Michelin stars and carved out an enviable reputation at the Ledbury in London, also on the world's 50 best list. Chef Brett Graham. Passionate about his native Peru, his Central restaurant in Lima took the top spot on Latin America's 50 best restaurants for three consecutive years and is in the top five of the world's best restaurants. Chef Virgilio Martinez. Honored with the Lifetime Achievement Award at Asia's 50 Best Restaurants 2013. He is the mind behind Ultraviolet in Shanghai, which has held three Michelin stars since 2017 and is ranked in the world's 50 best restaurants. Chef Paul Perret. Completely self-taught, she's now an ambassador for Slovenian cuisine, and the entire world is familiar with her restaurant, Isa Franco. Her drive and talent saw her named world's best female chef in 2017. Chef Anna Ross.
Welcome to all of you judges. Please reach the center of the stage. I know you're all used to great challenges, but I bet it's been a hard task to judge this 21 young chef. So I'd like to ask Dominique Crenn. We will later discover the role of the mentors, but you've been one. You've been the winner mentor last year. So yeah. Does that make you be more sympathetic to this young chef this year?
Sympathetic? I'm not sure.
Generous, maybe?
No, I mean, it gave me a different viewpoint, and I've been in those guys' shoes, so just don't be nervous, it's gonna be okay. No, it just gave us a different way of looking at things and understanding that everyone that has been competing today has been just amazing, and the level has been out there, and it's about understanding who they are, and at the end of the day, it's about respecting each other.
Good to hear. Virgilio, what impressed you the most looking at the work of these guys?
Well, these guys, they are very committed, very focused on what they have to do. And actually, they were like doing a very good representation of their regions, their food, their countries. So basically, every single place has a story, mm-hmm. A beautiful story behind.
Annie, I was working with your colleagues. You fought over who should win, or you get along well?
Look at them. They are all very nice. And I didn't know them. But of course, it was a pleasure. And we became all friends. And we had very good ideas and difficulties. But of course, it's a pleasure. And I hope to see them again, because they are fantastic. Thank you very much.
Okay. Annie, in your hands is the envelope. Inside the envelope is the name of tonight's winner. I don't know who won, because I'm the worst in keeping secrets, so it's better that way. So, judges, please take your seats. And you're going to tell me the name at the end. So, in the last couple of days, the young chef got here in Milan for the grand finale in two slots yesterday, and they prepared their signature dishes, and they were judged by the seven sages right after. So we will soon get a selection of their best dishes, and most of the audience has followed the competition, but while they go to the kitchen, and Angela is taking them to the kitchen in a while, I think it's time to let's take a look to how the young chef lived the last past days.
De Chile a Milán es un viaje muy largo, pero estoy muy feliz de estar aquí.
I'm in love with Milan.
Estoy emocionado por la competencia.
It's going to be a great experience for me.
It's great to be one of the finalists.
We're really lucky actually here to meet all the best young chefs in the world.
This is me. I am ready.
Sanpellegrino Young Chef has a stunning organization.
The day has come. We start the competition.
Meeting other chefs is inspiring.
My ingredients are very important to me.
I will present the food culture of Taiwan.
I am very focused.
The presentation time is the most challenging part to me.
They are doing a great job today.
C'était bien passé. On va voir les jurys qu'est-ce qu'elle va décider.
We try to make all the things perfect, but the level is.
I think with a challenge like this, there's always improvements that can be made. Always.
I'm really satisfied with the end result. Yes, I am.
Very happy with the dish, very happy with the flavors, and yeah, very proud to represent South East Asia.
I'm happy. I'm relieved. I've been waiting for that moment for like a year. Of course, I would enjoy winning. Who doesn't?
I'm here with Francesca Barberini. Hello, Francesca.
Hello.
Nice to see
Hi,
you again.
Alexandra.
You're here from the first edition?
Yes.
You've been reporting what happened in the last 2 days. What do you think
yes.
most changed in this competition
okay.
since the first one?
So one of the things that impressed me most, apart from the talent, of course, of the young chef, was that we really traveled all around the world in these 2 days. So it was amazing. You know, food is a language, and we have all in common. And so the young chef spoke to, told us the story, told us who they are, and their culture, their roots. And this year, I think, more than ever. Another thing is the strong relationship with their mentors. You know, most of them told me that they were really impressed by the skills of these guys and girls, of course. So I think that the level is higher and higher. And this is, I think, also because the great job that Alma has done. And you know that Alma selected the application.
Mm-hmm.
And so they've really done a great job. Can I say thank to Andrea Sinigaglia, who is the Alma general manager. And it was really amazing. And you know, they're really emotionless. They give emotion to us. And because the manager, they mastered the techniques. So when you master the technique, you can give emotion with a dish. So I was really impressed by this year.
Nice. Mr. Sinigaglia, you want to add something?
Yes, just a little few things. Thanks, Sanpellegrino. We have a long-lasting relation with Sanpellegrino. I'd like to thank to ask us to be part of this great competition. But first of all, they ask us to get a huge responsibility because we made a strong work behind the stage, making the selection of the 1,000 recipes and young chef, and also with a technical support in these days. I all want to say that tonight we are living in a beautiful frame, what we live in Alma every day. So we are seeing young people looking for their destiny, and this is rich of electricity, and it's fantastic. So we feel like at home. Thank you,
Mrs. Senigallia.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Francesca.
Thank you. See you next year.
See you next year.
Of course.
Same place. Now I ask the control room to open the live feed with the kitchens. Angela should be there. Hey, Angela, you're back in the crime scene. These are the actual kitchen where they work. They're not working. They're not cooking right now. Is the tension over? Yeah, I bet they are tough enough, but is there something that the winner should have for sure? I'd like to ask Paul. Yeah, you want... I handle the mic.
What else than talent? I don't know if I can say it without being indecent. So, basically, it depends on what you want to... How do you want to define talent? I think talent doesn't fall from a tree. And talent encompass already everything you need to have at this level. And it's stamina, courage, passion. All those elements are what we call talent.
Okay, and Margarita, what about the dishes? Do you think the guys follow the global trend or they're more focused on the culture?
I think that it was quite refreshing to see that nearly all the finalists looked to tradition for inspiration and looked into their own culture and personal experiences. Although there was much, of course, modernity in the execution of the dishes, but the essence of nearly all the entries came from their own hearts and their own culture. And I think that it says a lot about the future of gastronomy because they're the ones who are going to carry the torch in the future. And if tradition is where they're now looking for inspiration, it's great because all of that has nearly been lost, and it would be so nice for gastronomy to look back to the old things for inspiration.
Yeah, I'm really curious to see their work. Now it's time for the first selection in this grand finale. Each judge will name one finalist. Angela.
So that's true. Now we're going to call on the seven sages to help us narrow down the selection from 21 chefs to seven. So I've corralled up all of the chefs in groups of three. So first up, we have Dominique Kren, if you could please help us choose between Chef Vusi, Chanwai, and Falco.
Chef Vusi. Please come to the stage.
Congratulations, Chef Vusi. You are moving on. You are one of the chosen one. Thank you, Dominique. Okay, and now my next group of three, if I could please ask Chef Annie, if you could do us the honor to choose. Do we have Chef Antonio, Chef John Rivera, and Chef Frederic?
So please, come John Rivera, please. Come here.
Congratulations, John. That's a look of joy for sure. Okay, and now up next, I have my next three chefs next to me. Margarita, if you could please do us the honor to choose between Chef Yasuhiro, Chef Kilan, and Chef John Taube.
Chef Yasuhiro, please come forward.
Chef Yasuhiro, congratulations. You're one of the seven chosen ones. And now as we move on again, I have my next three. If I could please ask Chef Brett, if you could please choose between Constantina, David Valti, and Zi Yang Chen.
Chef David Valti.
Congratulations, David. Okay, so we have three more up here. This point of time, I would like to ask Chef Paul Perret if you could please choose from Eduardo, Jake Kelly, and Benjamin.
Jake Kelly, please come forward.
Jake, congratulations, you're moving on. And now, up next, if I could please ask Chef Virgilio if you could choose between Chef Ruslan, David Andres, and Oscar Segundo.
Please, David, come to the stage. David.
David, congratulations, you're moving on. And now I have my last three. Chef Anna, could you please help us to choose between Chef Marquin, Chef Elizabeth, and Chef Anton?
Can I say no? It's so difficult. I can understand it's even harder for them. But I'm really honored. Eastern Europe got it. Marcin, can you step forward?
Congratulations to all of our chefs.
Okay, Angela, so we have the Magnificent Seven. They have been chosen, so we wait for you here on stage. I'd like to ask Chef Anna, is there a common feature that linking all of this chef, or you just decided to award their uniqueness?
It's a very difficult question. I think there is a link between all of them, that's passion and love for what they're doing. And I don't know if any of us told you how hard work we had, because the participants really did an amazing and great job. So it wasn't easy for us. And another thing I would like to say is that with them, we really learned a lot. I don't think I speak only for myself, but for all of us. Understanding how to judge these great young people, it's not really the easiest task. Anyhow, I think what we really searched for was the heart in these people, which make them being unique at the end of the day. So the message we are sending is that copy-pasting is something that should be totally out. All of us, we should be searching the truth in the kitchen, in ourselves, in our heart, in our souls, and then express it through our hands. So this is the message from
Good.
This journey.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We are reaching the top right here. What did inspire the young chef through the competition? Let's take a look to the golden rule that brought them here. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Magnificent Seven, the seven best ranked young chefs in 2018. These are the young chefs that made it so far. Angela, you saw them working. What impressed you the most?
Oh my goodness, over the past 2 days, there were so many impressive things. We saw one of the chefs actually try to recreate cooking here in these show kitchens, a dish that is from his home country where they usually cook it in soil and wrap it with fire and coal, and so then he recreated it here. You know what else we saw that was very interesting?
Tell me.
One of the chefs even brought with them a hydroponic system because he wanted to be able to press pesticide-free beets here for us.
Wow. Can you help us understand a little bit more about their dishes?
I think I can. Why don't we come and chat to some of the chefs now that we have them all lined up here as well. So now, Chef Vusi, how are you feeling? Okay, everybody, don't be stressed. Whatever's happening right now, just don't be stressed. So in your dish, you actually put pure heritage on a plate with your 5-week-aged duck, and you also use the duck leg. And you said something to the chefs that was quite interesting, that you wanted to play with the flavors for a mind trick. Talk us about how that mind trick worked in your favor to get you here today.
Well, I didn't know it was going to work, so it worked. So I wanted to cook the dish over fire, as you would do at home, but I couldn't do that here. So I tried to incorporate smokiness in a different way. So I took the duck legs and I dried them out and I smoked like the hell out of them.
They were pretty black. They were just...
Yeah. Everyone thought like, this is rubbish, throw it away. But like, no, they have to go to Milan. So we grated that duck over everything else. So it presented that smokiness without actually being aggressive. So yeah.
And it seems like the judges have also agreed with you that it wasn't too aggressive. Congratulations on making it to the final seven. Okay, so now coming up next, John. This is an easy dish for me to speak about because I find it so interesting. So you did an elevated sinigang. And sinigang is normally a dish of soup that's maybe made out of water in tamarind sauce. But you used tamarind in two different ways on your dish. One way was with the roasted tamarind. And you also grated some, dusted it over your chicharron, perhaps. Now, tell me, why is that chicharron so important to you?
It's important, I guess, because in Australia we have a big philosophy on not wasting any part of the animal. So when kind of tasked with making a textural element of this dish, we looked at the fish head that we usually would almost always make fish head sinigang. And I love eating the cheeks, the eyes, all those gelatinous parts. So we took that, took all those parts from the head, really took all the meat off and cooked that with rice, which is really important to me as well because I come from kind of like the rice capital of the Philippines. So we cooked that, made a cracker, and then we dusted it with a native Australian tamarind, rainforest tamarind, grown up in Queensland, which is kind of like the link between Philippines and Australia because both are great like tamarinds.
Oh, that's fantastic! I didn't actually know that tamarind grew natively in Australia as well. Is there a difference in flavor at all between the Australian tamarind and what you'd find in Southeast Asia?
Yeah, there is. So the tamarind in Southeast Asia is a lot sweeter, or if it's ripe, it's a lot sweeter, and it's very kind of rich and syrupy and molassesy. The ones from the rainforest, they're very fragrant. It's when I first got them from the lady that we get it from in Australia, it smelt like the rainforest. And when I dehydrated it, it never lost that freshness. And I hope it translated onto the chicharron.
Fascinating. And so for those of you that don't know, chicharron in the Philippines is like a snack that you eat every day made out of pig skin. So you replicated that using the fish guts and rice, as you would. Okay, congratulations, John. Okay, so now John, I'm going from John to John. So you had an aged, actually you did something that was interesting. You did beak to tail, basically. And you aged your pigeon, which included a duck tart, skewered hearts, a smoked pigeon broth. Now, pick one bite off of that entire plate that you would say is your favorite.
I'd have to say probably the tartlet. A massive inspiration behind my dish was to keep it all Australian. In the tartlet, on the outside, we have a beautiful flower from South Australia, on Kangaroo Island. Inside the tartlet, we have some beautiful Daintree chocolate from the Daintree in North Queensland. A little fermented blackberry, and then the parfait, the livers from the pigeon, we made a parfait. And then on top, Queensland cane sugar, just a brulee on top, so when you eat it, you get that nice little crunch.
So can you tell me, why is beak to tail so important to you?
Oh, I think using any animal nose to tail is a massive thing within restaurants these days. You know, you want to utilize everything. Mm-hmm. You don't want anything to go to waste. It's a philosophy that sort of adapted me in an early age of my career, and it's something I thrive on through what I want to serve.
That's fantastic. We love seeing all of those pieces on the plate like that. That's gorgeous. And congratulations, Jake, for moving on. So now, Yasuhiro, I don't know if you're going to speak to me or not, because as you made your announcement to all of the jury members that in your culture from Japan, that people don't speak very much, but that the passion runs very deep. And so as we want to speak about this, passion running very deep. Your dish, you brought the Ayu fish with you from Japan, but one of the components on your dish was the water of the river. So you wanted to replicate the sense of the river water. Can you tell me what you did in order to bring out some of those aromas?
In the rivers where Ayu lives, the fish lives, if you go in the summer, like you smell this cucumber, like watermelon aroma, which is coming from the fish itself. And yeah, I wanted to express that with the little drink here. And I made this from cucumber, watermelon, melon and green tomatoes, which all have you know, this green flavors, you know, and they're very clear, very cold.
So one of the other things that's interesting is nobody in our audience that we're streaming live to as well will be able to smell or taste that dish. But also with the Ayu fish, it's not very commonly found across the world. Can you tell us more about some of the flavors there and how you cooked it in order to actually make those shine?
Ayu is only found in East Asia, especially in Japan. We value it very much because first, because of its seasonality, we can only eat Ayu during 2 months of the year, or 2 or 3 months of the year in the summer. And in Japan, we normally grill it, the whole fish, and we eat from head to tail, crispy head, sweet. The flesh is actually, flesh tastes very sweet, and the guts is very bitter. And I try to create the taste, but like usually, you know, the head, it's not very common outside Japan to eat the fish head. And also this bitterness of the gut is not appreciated very often by, you know, non-Japanese people. So I wanted to make it, you know, less mild, but like still maintaining the flavor of Ayu.
Right, okay, fantastic. So you took out a little bit of the bitterness and moved the head because some people wouldn't be so interested in eating it today. Thank you so much. And now moving on, David, you decided to use tuna in such a sustainable way. If you look at David's dish, not only do we have the tuna bones and the spine on the plate, but you also use the exterior of the skin. Now, if you had just to choose one favorite of everything that's on this dish, because everything was a small component that you could eat on its own, which one would you choose?
Bueno, disculpar, yo hablo muy mal inglés delante de tanta gente.
We'll get the translator here for a second. Hi, hello. Come join us.
I'm very sorry, he says, but I mean, since there is such a distinguished audience, he would prefer to speak Spanish.
That's fine.
Como has dicho, mi plato era una declaración de intenciones de cocina sostenible.
My dish was basically a declaration of supporting sustainable cuisine.
Porque considero que en todos los aspectos, pero sobre todo en el mar, tenemos que empezar una pesca sostenible, pero sobre todo los cocineros empezar a mandar mensajes de que tenemos que cuidar y aprovechar todos y cada uno de los pescados que salga del mar de la mejor forma posible.
Because I really think that sustainable fisheries should be promoted, and we as chefs should send this message that we should really use as much or basically everything that we can of a fish.
Yo intenté hacer un trabajo al máximo de acurado y exigente posible. Disculpar que os hice comer médula, piel, sangre y de todo.
And that's what I did. I really tried to use everything. Sorry, you found marrow and blood, but that was my intention, to use all of the tuna.
Pero la verdad que con este trabajo me he dado cuenta que tenemos que abrir los ojos y empezar a hacer una cocina más sostenible. Porque en vez de ir para adelante parece que vayamos para atrás, porque me he dado cuenta que haciendo recetas de más de 2000 años como un garum, aprovechaban mucho más los peces que salían del mar que ahora.
because this is a very important message that I would like to convey. It seems that we are not going forward towards sustainability, but rather the opposite, because in the past they used much more, for instance, with garum, they really exploited everything of the animal.
Y ya me callo del plato, solo agradecer a San Pellegrino, a toda la organización, al señor Clemón, porque yo soy muy pesado, es el tercer año que estoy aquí, pero no estoy aquí solo por ser pesado, sino porque, como veis, la organización de esta gente es maravillosa, el jurado es inmejorable y los mentores aún más. A mí me han dado la oportunidad de trabajar con ese año con el genio Oriol Castro y era imposible no venir aquí otra vez.
And I would like to thank all the organizers, Sanpellegrinos, the jury. You might think that, you know, you maybe are fed up with me because this is my third time here.
Of course not.
That shows that I really liked it. And this time I had the grand opportunity of working with the genius, that is Oriol Castro, and I couldn't not take advantage of it. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, David, thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, and now, ladies and gentlemen, I just want to highlight as well, when Annie walked out earlier, she actually had the envelope in her hand. There has been a winner that has been chosen. So everything that you say here will not sway the judges anymore. Okay, so David, your dish. I loved the tableside service and how you use the thyme leaves to bring out the oil. You also made this kombucha tea, which is incredibly popular around the world. And also we saw some other chefs that were using kombucha tea as well. Now, you had to roast your vegetables, strain your tea, roast and smoke your trout bones, and then strain your tea. What were you doing? What were you trying to achieve? Were you showing off your patience at that point of time? Is it because it's trendy? Tell me about how you chose using it.
I would not say because it's trendy. It's because it's a kind of a philosophy of a lifestyle. I mean, kombucha now it's trendy, that's true.
And tell me more about it.
We do it, I mean, I learned it from a colleague from our team about kombucha, and we started in our restaurant to experiment with that. And now we're doing it at home as well. And my girlfriend is not really happy with this because it smells something a little bit like vinegar. So that's why it's in the cellar, but there's the perfect temperature. But what I want to say is, it's not only kombucha. It's I used the roasted vegetables, as you said, and I didn't peel that vegetables because you can use the skins of the vegetables if you roast them for a nice flavor, for a caramelization, and that's why I, as the guys already said, you're using everything from an animal, but as well from vegetables.
Yes, of course.
It's very important for me.
Okay, fantastic. So you really did try and utilize every aspect possible. Thank you.
Yeah, I used the skin of the leek that I roasted in the oven. I used the trout bones of the fish, and of course the vegetables, the rest of the vegetables are inside of the tea. They are not peeled.
Yes, I love that process that you're telling us about the leek hearts as well, how you put them in the basement.
Thank you.
Really fascinating. And congratulations that you've moved on. You're one of our final seven. Now, last but not least, Markeen. Dish, this beautiful dish here. You were telling us previously, yesterday, that it was based on a salad that you normally have in your country with cucumber and fenugreek and dill. But then now you have this beautiful reconstructed salad all around your halibut. Can you tell us about some of the ingredients that we see here, including that bison grass?
Yeah, it's looking nice, really.
Doesn't it look nice on the floor
right,
like that?
It's a DNA of a region where I live. I live in North Poland. And out there, we're using a lot of smoked fish, actually. And I smoked this fish in a river, hay. And this is completely the construction of the traditional salad with cucumber and dill and creamy. My mother served in my house, I don't think, maybe four times in a week.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we always eat this with the white fish. And it's a deconstruction of this. I make a starfish from horseradish, and I put a lot of wild herbs, you see, then white currant leaves, the flowers of dill, the white orpine, the wild green garlic onion. It's actually, everything's now in the season in the North Poland. It's really, really a wild coast of the Baltic Sea. in the North Europe. You can find this everything out there, very close to sea, very close to biggest lake in Poland. It's my place in the world.
So you took us on a journey to your home. Yeah. Fantastic. Thank you so much. And good luck to our final seven.
Very interesting, guys. Good luck to each and every one of you. I'd like to ask the judges how the young age of the contestants influenced the dishes we just saw. Brett, you have the mic? No. I will handle it.
First of all, congratulations, guys. It's an amazing achievement. You seven guys standing out there in front of us. A lot of hard work to get there, so well done. I arrived here on Friday thinking that this was going to be an easy competition to judge for young chefs, but I was wrong. The quality of the cooking was far greater than your age, and it inspired all of us judges. It made us realize that the future of gastronomy around the world, parts of the world that I haven't been to, is in very safe hands. And I also want to say a little mention, probably from the jury, that on our left over there, the mentors, some of the finest chefs in the world, and chefs that I looked up to as a young chef like these guys, and to give your time out of your very busy schedules, we all very much appreciate and think it's amazing the support you gave them. So thank you.
We will get to their role in a while, but now it's time to move from seven to three young chef finalists. So the seven sages will give the go to reveal the three finalists. If the judges are ready, Brett, are you giving the sign to the control room? Let's go. First finalist is Jake Kelly from Southeast Asia. Congratulations. Finalist number two, Yasuhiro Fujio from Japan. Finalist number three is Martin Popielars from East Europe. Congratulations, guys. Congratulations to the three finalists. I guess this applause was for them. Give another one to the guys that didn't make it to the end. Thank you. So we have the three finalists. Did they tell you who's the winner is? Did they tell you who's the winner is?
You know what? You keep hounding me for this. I actually don't know.
The seven sages
wouldn't tell me because then I would tell you and then you would spoil the show.
That's fair. Fair enough. Yeah. There's another unique pillar. Brett just mentioned it. Another pillar that grants the excellence of this competition.
Yes. As Brett just mentioned, I would love to introduce you to all of our 21 kings and queens of restaurants all over the world. If we could please invite the mentors to come on stage.
Please, guys.
Mentors, please come and join us on stage. And during the entire year of the competition, each young chef has been supported with the idea of fine-tuning his or her dish by a starred chef, a real counselor, and, of course, a true inspiration for them. Young chefs in the kitchen have their own outlook. They can interpretate trends that are coming up, have contemporary views on food. They're very bold. But nothing gives you more value than having a strong guide. In the F&B industry, when you're looking at somebody's bio, you always look where they worked before and who they worked under. It's one thing that we always say, it's building on the shoulders of giants. So teachers and mentors often define chefs, and that is why this is such a huge feature for us here at Sanpellegrino Young Chef. Now, at this point of time, I would like to have Matteo Monti. Where are you, Matteo? Hi, come step forward here with me for just 1 second. Now, you came in last minute for Markeen. His mentor had to leave very abruptly. And so what was it like for you to help him with his dish?
I try to understand the idea of Marcin.
Yes, and very last minute.
Well, yeah, last minute. But you know, when you are in the same line, is nice to is easy to talk with the because we talk the same language. Of course, mm-hmm. I don't talk Polish and he don't talk Italian. But it's the language of the food, mm-hmm. the kitchen, and the heart we put in the kitchen. So it's really easy.
It was almost like you were a coach as well on that day because you did step in at last minute. You had to look at his timings and how he was doing, and all of his mise was done.
I don't understand.
That's okay. Sorry. That's fine.
My English
just
is terrible.
Smile with me. Sorry. We can all just smile together.
I try to taste mm-hmm. everything, and I try to give my idea of mm-hmm. the plate to Marcin. And Marcin have two mentors, so he need understand yes. Chef Amaro and mm-hmm. and me, and in the middle make the plate with his idea. So yeah, I think he's good, no?
Yes. He's one of our three super finalists. And honestly, I want to say thank you so much for jumping in to be his mentor at that point of time when he really needed somebody. And there you were to just help out. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure. Thank you to Sanpellegrino. Grazie.
Thank you. You can come here. You can stand with all of your colleagues as well. Okay, and so now where is Luca? Luca, let me find you. Hi, Luca. Come and join me over here. So now you helped with Yasuhiro and his IU fish. What was your role in mentoring?
Well, we spent the last, I think, 8 months to try to figure out how can work some Japanese with Italian. Uh-huh. But luckily, he can speak English. So it will be more easy to communicate. Mm-hmm. But you know, Japanese, they're very serious, very
yes.
professional, very, like he say, they don't speak that much, but they feel a lot.
Yes, exactly. And you're a very passionate country here in Italy, so you have a lot of passion behind you.
I live in Japan.
Yes. And so you've
now
learned
I've become
to...
half Japanese after 8 years. But I think it's a beautiful experience to me to be here today and to see a lot of colleagues, a lot of chefs, a lot of young generation is amazing.
Isn't it?
And I'm so happy for Fujio.
Yes.
He tried to bring his country in the dish, his culture, his philosophy, and everything in the dish. And I'm happy that the judge may understand this.
Yes, I think they did. Can I just ask you a question? Because you brought up that culturally it's very different because in Japan people don't speak their mind very much. And in Italy you have a very passionate people behind you. Did you get into any arguments? Was there any heated debates and disagreements?
But no. Really, argument, some discussion, yes.
Yes?
I'm strong.
Loud?
Mine.
Did it ever?
No, I didn't punch him. Really. We are very close to punch each other, but at the end, we peace and love. But some time was like difficult, but at the end, I think so we have a nice combination.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you so much,
Thank
Luca.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
All peace and love. Richard, come forward and join me over here. Now, we were just speaking about how important it is to have a mentor and a teacher in somebody's life. I know you started your career out very young, at 16. Now, tell me, what was all of the, how was your role with Jake, and what made it inspiring?
Well, first of all, I was very lucky to have been appointed Jake, because mm-hmm. he's an extremely passionate chef. For me, the most important was really to understand his philosophy behind the dish, because mm-hmm. what I did not want that it became an Ecobus dish. It needed to stay you know, the integrity of the dish needed to stay a Jay Kelly's dish. And
very much so, with all of his Australian-ness behind
totally,
it.
Totally. So we basically look into what we felt that was strong and amplify that. And we looked in some of the areas where we felt there needed a little bit more thought and a little bit more work. Mm-hmm. And there was a lot of back and forth call through FaceTime. So, you know, modern communication really helps.
So just so that everybody knows, so Richard, you live in Hong Kong and Jake lives in Singapore. That's why FaceTime was a big, came into play a lot for them.
Yes, yes.
So now you have so much experience behind you. Did you gain anything from being a mentor as well?
I mean, listen, the beauty of this trade is that we work every day with young people, and it's not only what I pass on, it's also what I receive. You know, it's a mutual passage on of great ideas and different views. And that keeps me young as well, you know. It's one of the most motivational things of our job, I think, and that's why I'm doing it. And the older I think you get, the more you feel that part actually becomes much more important. When you're very young, you're very driven, think it's all about you, and you see very quickly it's all about the team, it's all about how we get there together, and it is how we do that by investing a lot of time and energy in these young chefs. I always say you can come and work for me and you can add it onto your CV, but you have to leave here a better person and a better chef.
That's so true. Yeah, let's have a huge round of applause for that. Okay, thank you so much, Richard.
Thank you, and big news, because this year in Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2018, the mentors have been given also another role. This year, not only they were mentors, they were judges too, because they've been asked to betray their young chef and vote for the one they think should win the competition. So I ask Mr. Stefano Marini, Business Executive Officer, IBU, Sanpellegrino Group, to join us on stage.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Ciao, everybody. Please allow me just to, first of all, thanks to all the people here for being here, and thanks to those who are following the live stream on our digital platform, and thank a lot. This is Panna Time, Acqua Panna Time. So this is the award based on the taste of authenticity. As you know, Acqua Panna is our premium still mineral water that, together with Sanpellegrino, is on the table of the best restaurants across the world, and maybe this is something that everybody knows. But maybe not all knows that Acqua Panna has a long tradition. Basically, its origin started more than 450 years ago, in year 1564. So a long tradition of this brand, and since then, Acqua Panna has been flowing smoothly and velvety across the Tuscan hills. And is getting the terroir or the beautiful Tuscany in its taste. That's why the taste is authentic. So I told you a story, because what has been asked to our 21 mentor is exactly to choose one young chef, the one that was able to better tell his own story within the dish, and at the same time to valorize the ingredients in the dish. So not an easy task, and maybe it's a good thing just to make a big applause to the 21 mentors for this. So the mentors came to an agreement on one name. So the winner of the Acqua Panna Award is Yasuhiro Fujio from Japan.
Congratulations.
So, congratulations.
Please stop for a photo. There you go. Thank you.
This for you.
A huge round of applause. Luca, can you step forward as well? Come step forward. as you were the mentor, and this is the Mentor's Award, just come and step forward for just a quick second. Yasuhiro, would you like to say a few words, as now the mentors have all chosen you to win this award, the Authenticity Award?
I just want to say thank you for picking me. Very surprised. Yes. Thank you.
Okay, and now Luca, since you are the mentor, you want to coach him on some things that he can say to make the audience fall in love with him.
You can sing something more, I think so. Everybody is very tense now. Everybody, you need to be relaxed because you get some award, no?
He's focused.
Yeah, focus. Yeah, he's finished the competition. He's already done. Yeah. He's finished. You're already here.
Okay, I guess I used my focus on the cooking, and yeah, there's no more left.
No. Thank you, Yasuhiro. I'll see you later, as you are one of the three finalists. So, congratulations for this award. And we'll see you later. Thank you, Stefano. Thank you to all the mentors. A big round of applause to the 21 mentors once again. And thank you, Angela.
Thank you.
I'll see you. Yeah, you can all have a seat, because someone came to visit Sanpellegrino, young chef, and I think it's someone you may have heard of.
In a moment in which the world is building walls, we are breaking walls. This is a cultural project. Our goal is to fight waste. Teach the real heroes of this project, the volunteers, how to transform unwanted ingredients into healthy and delicious meals. The more we are, the louder we will be. We can all make visible the invisible.
Please welcome Massimo Bottura, founder of Food for Soul. Ciao Massimo. Benvenuto. Please. So we saw in the video refectorios are popping up.
You brought a chair because I'm getting old.
Yeah, from my house. Yeah. Getting lazy.
Where's Yoshiro?
Getting lazy. Yoshiro is over there, I think.
Yeah, where? Come on, express yourself.
Massimo, what about the refectorios? We saw they're popping up all over the world. What's in the future?
As a dream, I dream that it would be normality. Mm-hmm. You know, there are so many, you know, examples that are popping up now. You know, the last one was in Switzerland, the one before in UK. So there are so many chefs that are like really into this project. And you know, we are setting the examples since 3 years ago. We share this kind of idea, this kind of ethic, project, and all together we can make the difference, and we are making the difference. As the future for Food for Soul can be, you know, a platform which we are working with Salesforce in San Francisco, in which we put together names of volunteers from all over the world, and are really incredible. It's so many people that are applying. And actually, we were talking with Dominique that maybe San Francisco could be the next. But and also, it would be, I don't know, an ice cream place in Thessalonica, mm-hmm. in the refugee camp in Thessalonica, or a bakery in Ethiopia. I was in a piazza before, and all with the Franciscan monks, and we already got the money they're gonna move the whole container full of equipment in Ethiopia. Yeah. So, it's about that. There is a very strong group of people, you know, that they share this kind of ethic idea. They put the ethic close to the aesthetic part. So it's getting very, very interesting future.
Okay, Massimo, tonight there's also a surprise you brought us.
I don't know. I asked these guys that they didn't do too much, but they're ready to play with food, and so ready for the kitchen, eh?
Okay, because tonight we will have a great signature dinner.
Yeah, with that they all they said yes, you know, of course. It's, yeah. You know, they're like we are cooking for you all guys, and I hope.
Good for us. Massimo, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
And good luck on everything, really.
I hope so.
Big applause to Massimo Bottura.
Thank you.
Ciao, Massimo. We are getting close to know the name of the young chef 2018, but before diving into the final moment, there's another big surprise and another special guest for us. ...26-year-old from UK, platinum with Leave a Light On. More than 76 million streams on Spotify, more than 72 million views on YouTube. Back on Europe, next fall, please welcome Tom Walker.
Second, someone mentioned you were all alone. I could feel the trouble coursing through your veins. Now I know it's got a hold. Just a phone got left unanswered, had me sparking up. These cigarettes won't stop me wondering where you are. Don't let go. Into the distance is a house upon the hill, guiding like a lighthouse. It's a place where you'll be safe to feel our grace. We've all made mistakes. If you've lost your way, well, I will leave the light on. Well, I will leave the light on. No, no, no. Well, I will leave the light on. What's been on your mind? Lately you've been searching for a darker place to hide. That's alright. But if you carry on abusing, you'll be rough from eyes. I refuse to lose another friend to drugs. Just come home. Don't let go. If you look into the distance, there's a house upon the hill, guiding like a lighthouse. It's a place where you'll be safe to feel our grace. We've all made mistakes. If you've lost your way, well, I will leave the light on. Well, I will leave the light on. No, no, no. Well, I will leave the light on. Upon the hill, guiding like a lighthouse. It's a place where you'll be safe to feel like Christ. If you've lost your way, if you've lost your way. And I know you're down and out now, but I need you to be brave. Hiding from the truth, ain't gonna make this all okay. I see your pain, you don't feel like grace. And you've lost your way. Well, I will leave the light on. Well, I will leave the light on.
Tom Walker, everyone. Hello, nice to meet you, Tom. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm pretty good. Congratulations on your record. It's a massive hit, great song. Congratulations. But the funny thing is that I just found out that before starting your singing career, you were a cook, right?
Yeah, not a very good cook. Yeah. So, you know, don't expect much. But yeah, I was a chef for 4 years before I did music.
Yeah, how did it go? How was that experience?
It was amazing. I make a great fish and chips, like the best.
Okay.
Maybe not the best, but I mean, it's at least mediocre.
Okay, so maybe you could have been one of those guys.
Yeah, maybe.
The level is too high.
Yeah, I mean, it was a real passion for me at some point, and I really enjoyed it. And, you know, it's kind of similar to music. It's a huge buzz to be in a kitchen, and when you get something right, mm-hmm. and you perform correctly, it's great.
It's amazing, yeah.
And also, when it all goes wrong, it's very stressful.
Yeah, I bet it is. So, Tom, thank you very much. I know we will see you again tonight.
I'll be back.
Yeah, there's Absolutely. Another song for us, so yeah. Can't wait to see you.
Thank you.
Cheers. Tom Walker. And we're really close to know the name inside the envelope, so I would like to ask once again Angela to join me on stage, and I'd like to start thanking who made this event possible. Supporting the Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2018 Nespresso. Round of applause for Nespresso, for Fresco Baldi Toscana, Electrolux, Giblers, Pentola Agnelli.
And of course, can we have a huge round of applause for all of the young chefs that brought with them all of their drive and passion.
And I'd like to ask Federico Sarzi Braga, President and CEO of Sanpellegrino, to come with us for this great final. Welcome, Federico. If you have something to say.
Would you like to say a few words?
Yeah. First of all, buonasera to everyone. And let me just thank you, thank everyone that are the key protagonists of this wonderful Sanpellegrino Young Chef for 2018. So please help me with a big round of applause for the nice jury. Thank you very much. The mentors, thank you. The Young Chef. And all the people that are, and this is my personal thank you, all the people that are behind the scene, in the background, that helped to make it happen. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
As you know, Sanpellegrino is a unique mineral water. It's a powerful brand. And is with a global vision, international reach. But we are so proud, so proud to have our deep roots in the Italian excellence. That's why we are here today in Milano, and we put a spotlight on talent that are coming from all over the world. Because as a Sanpellegrino, we understand, we value the power of diversity, the power of blending different cultures, the power of blending different generations. And we started this amazing journey more than 1 year ago. And we were looking for, with several key small and big local or regional events, we were looking for talent. And we were looking for 21 emerging chefs. And we were thinking to look for a talent. But as you have experienced in these 3 days, we found much more than that. We found passion. We found determination. We found authentic people. We found ambition. We found skills, hard work. We found a lot of dreams. And these dreams are the ones that we want to feed, and we will continue to feed, because that's our mission, that's our ambition, is to protect the heritage of the gastronomy that was giving us a lot in our 100 years of history, and it's time now to give back something. to protect the heritage and to guarantee, to help to guarantee a brilliant and even brighter future for this wonderful world, for this wonderful community. So thank you for joining us. Thank you for supporting our exciting journey that we have in front of us. Good luck to the young chef for the top three, the top seven, and the top 21 coming from all over the world. But it's now time, I guess, to discover who is the winner for
it. Is.
We will be the Sanpellegrino Young Chef for 2018.
Yeah, it is. So please, I'd like to ask the jury to join us on stage, bring the envelope with the name of the winner. Please, all of the seven sages can come here on stage and make some noise for the three finalists. Guys, please. Guys, come here in front of everyone. That's your moment. The three finalists.
We'll have our three finalists just to the front.
Are you nervous? Yeah, just a little bit. Good luck, guys. Good luck. Where's the envelope? Okay. No. Now I need to know. Now that's my moment also. Can I have? Yeah. Okay. So this is the moment. The three finalists are here. They wanted to know who is the winner, and the name of the winner is written inside this envelope. We have Yasuhiro Fujio, we have Jay Kelly, we have Martin Popielarch. But the winner is just one of them, and his name is the winner of Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2018. Is Yasuhiro Fujio. Good job, Yasuhiro. Congratulations. Yasuhiro Fujio is the winner of Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2018. A big applause to Jay Kelly and Martin Popielarch also. Great job, guys.
And where is Luca? Luca, can you come and join us on stage as well?
Yasuhiro, you want to keep also the envelope as a souvenir? Yeah, you will remember that moment. Yeah. Yasuhiro, you want to say something now? It's your moment. Now or never. Now or never.
Do you have that?
We have a microphone. We lost the microphone. Yeah, there's another one. Okay.
I lost one. Yasuhiro, please say a few words.
I think it's my day. I just want to say like a huge thank you to Luca, who's been supporting me. For all these times, and also his team in Tokyo, Bulgari, and also my head chef in Osaka, my family and everyone. You know, the juries, everyone here.
Good luck for your career, Yasuhiro, to you and to all the 21 young chefs.
You know, I don't consider myself as the best young chef of the world. Especially because after seeing, you know, all these 20 talented young chefs, and also I'm gonna be 31 this year, so I'm not so young anymore. And also, I'm a little bit scared right now because, you know, I know I'm going to have to work even harder, and it's my responsibility to bring up this title of Sanpellegrino Young Chef, you know. So all I'm gonna do is try to turn that fear into a courage to, you know, keep going, become a great chef. Thank you very much.
Yeah, so I know Tom Walker as another surprise for all of us and for Yashuhiro also. Please welcome Tom Walker again on stage. That's a great way to start a career, Yashuhiro. Thank you. Thank you. Please, guys, don't move. We have a wonderful dinner waiting for us. We have another great exhibition from Tom Walker. Once again, big applause to the winner of the Sanpellegrino Young Chef 2018. And once again, give it up for Tom Walker. Please, Tom, yeah, we will enjoy the night. Thank you very much. We can all have a seat and make party, and the night is... He's young.
She prays for a better man, and no need for your touching hands. There's nothing I understand, 'cause I'm on with the lost and damned. It's a long road when you're on your own. Take care of my broken soul, 'cause there must be Well, I've drank out of MRDs, too young for these memories. Swing no bitter melodies, false hope from the teeth of the enemy. So long road when you're on your own. Take care of my broken soul, 'cause there must be angels guiding the way. Well, there must be angels saving our grace, 'cause there must be heaven for people who stray. Well, there must be heaven in this hell that I'm living, 'cause heaven seems to be so forgiving. So I don't give up, I won't give up. No, don't give up. 'Cause there must be angels, there must be heaven in this hell that I'm living, 'cause heaven seems to be so forgiving. Well, lost hope keeping dreams afloat. I stand just a man on a tightrope. Got faith, but I'll never know. And I see wings when I look through my telescope. So long road when you're on your own. Take care of my broken soul, 'cause there must be angels guiding the way. Well, there must be angels saving our grace, 'cause there must be heaven for people who stray. Well, there must be heaven in this hell that I'm living, 'cause heaven seems to be so forgiving. So I don't give up, I won't give up. No, I don't give up, I 'cause there must be angels. Well, there must be angels. There must be heaven in this hell that I'm living, 'cause heaven seems to be so forgiving. Well, I don't give up, I won't give up, no. Don't give up, I 'cause there must be angels. Well, there must be angels. There must must be heaven in this hell that I'm living. Cause heaven seems to be so forgiving. Guys, thank you so much. Thank you so much to S.Pellegrino. Enjoy your evening. Cheers.
And ladies and gentlemen, a huge round of applause for Tom Walker. And at this point of time, thank you all so much for joining us for S.Pellegrino 2018. But of course, is not over yet. There is a fantastic dinner awaiting all of you that has been prepared by Massimo, as he told you earlier, and our seven sages. So if you'll please all make your way towards the exits that are on the right side of the room. We look forward to seeing you over there. Thank you.